Rosie, it's Michael from Red Chair Diaries. Congratulations on your losing your YouTube virginity hair, except as a background character with Chris. So you're going to show him up. It's very, very good. You did a good job, I think. Sometimes you rushed a bit, but people do, and whereas I'm kind of more slow. I wanted to talk about your love for The Phantom of the Opera. I have such an abiding love for Andrew Lloyd Webber's musicals, and I have no guilt about that as a guilty pleasure, because I enjoy them immensely. When Phantom came out as a musical, I was so excited. I went to the theater because it had been announced many years. Pardon me, at one point, there are so many different big stars associated with it, you know. Now I can't remember them, but I'll get to it. But when he hired Joel Shoemaker, and Andrew Lloyd Webber agreed that they would have a young cast, as opposed to, you know, trying to shoehorn established stars into it. And I think it worked out really well. I got chills when the opening sequence went from the debris and the dust of the Paris Opera House, and then all that, you know, there was a wash of red going up the theater's seats, and then everything became fresh. I thought that was stunning. I just love that so much. Just thinking about it, I get goosebumps. I've watched it several times. And I love the music from it. It's not my favorite musical of Lloyd Webber's. That one is Sunset Boulevard. That's in close competition with Evita. And I went to the theater to see Jesus Christ Superstar in the early 70s, you see. So, I mean, I just love that. I love that stuff. And I hope you love Evita. Have you ever seen that? I've seen it on stage. I've seen it in the movies a few times. I finally got around to buying a copy a few months ago. One of the $5 Walmart specials. Love that music so much. And Madonna did a great job. Meryl Streep was associated with that for ages. And by the time it was made, you know, she had aged out of the part, actually. So that's some background for you if you don't know it. My favorite musical is Les Mis. I have seen it at least 6 times. Still not made into a movie. And I saw it the first time Australia was in Sydney, Australia. The second time was in Vancouver. The third time was in Perth, Australia. The fourth time was in, I think, Halifax, and then I finally saw it in London, actually, one time. But I still think I saw it 6 times, and I'm forgetting a place. So anyway, that's a piece of information for you. What else? Australia, I have that copy of that movie. I only watched a few minutes. I mean, I'm going to go and watch the whole movie, because I do love Australia, and I do want to see that movie. And it got a lot of bad reviews, but, you know, sometimes people don't understand romantic epics, you know, and critics expect too much, and just shut up and just watch the movie, you know, let other people enjoy it. So that's what I'm looking forward to. When you were talking about Nancy Drew, I was never a fan of Nancy Drew on screen, but I do admit I read several Nancy Drew books when I was in grade 5, when I started reading The Hardy Boys and Nancy Drew. And what else did you show? Anyway, I can't remember everything that you showed. Oh, you know, the Narnia books, I'm always surprised about how big they are in the States, because those are English books. I've never read them, but they are very, very much British. And in Canada, there was a lot of the British influence, you know, but excuse me. I'm going to use that as a trademark, me yawning, because it seems to come up all the time. I've not been interested in seeing the movies nor in reading the books. I think they're a bit too Christian for me to really want to get into them. Anyway, yeah, a pretty good job there. I think what I might want to see in a future video is if you could get a better camera, because that one kind of washed you out a bit. And I believe you're going to university or college beginning this week, probably. I would like to hear about adventures, about what that's like these days, because I went so long ago and I loved my 3 years in university. And I don't think enough people talk about that, you know, make some blogs about that. It could be interesting to people, you know. I mean, what are the pressures now? There's so much connectivity in university, but are people any more close to each other than when I went? You know what I mean? Because you've got all your social networks, you've got your IT that you deal with now. We didn't have any of that, you know. We had to, I wrote my papers by hand. So, you know, it was a cursive writing. Does anybody still do cursive? Do you know how to do cursive? So that, I think, would be interesting. And anyway, you can see how connected and how articulate and how intelligent you are. So that certainly comes through. There weren't very many ums and ahs. So, you know, you were quite committed to your material there. Okay, well, I think that's enough, and it's 12:30 Saturday night here, and I did a shift at the seafood counter, but I want to get down and see this video and make some comments for you. Anyway, Michael from Red Chair Diaries and Rosie, we'll see you around the tube.